about, again, some of the causes. And genetics seems to be a factor in so many conditions and so many diseases that we hear about. So is genetics kind of, again, the key factor here, or is it really a combination of different things that can lead to epilepsy?
It could be either or both, meaning it can be a genetic component in which patients are more predisposed to seizures, or a genetic condition that actually is associated with seizures, or sometimes with a predisposition, but you get an insult to the brain, then you have seizures in, you know, that is probably in a result of a combination of factors. Now, Dr. Servin mentioned something that's very interesting, and it's true. There is a stigma to this condition sometimes, and not so much now, but in the past, patients would thought to be possessed. And you know, they were basically hidden from the population, and the condition would not be diagnosed for some time. And that was in the past. And there's still some stigma, maybe not so much in civilized, but in the third world countries, they are, there's the stigma that sometimes they get hidden and the diagnosis gets delayed.